As the player of the year, he's capable of making big shots.
Shamit with a drive inside, and he was fouled. So they're really taking it in. They're forcing Illinois State, Dan, to gamble here. And they're getting called, the Redbirds, for some fouls. Sending the Shockers inside. Timeout from St. Louis.
The ingredients here at Chipotle are the finest in all of the land. So at their request, we threw them a fest to honor their flavors so grand.
Like, really good.
They insisted we prepare them by hand, as we showered them with seasoning and praise. Entertaining and marinating, sauteing and celebrating, 'twas truly the most delicious of days.
Hey, hon. We gotta go. Come on.
At the border of failure and success, life will ask, do you have steel courage, the greatest old spice shampoo ever? Huh, I say to life, impeccably smooth and great smelling hair is my middle name. It's an administrative nightmare.
Why do we snack? Because we have nothing better to do? Well, people who snack on almonds have something better to do. Almonds are heart healthy and full of energy, with the crunch that keeps you in the game. California almonds. Crunch on.
Back at the Valley Conference Championship, these two teams split a decision in the regular season, January 14th in Normal. McIntosh powering the Redbirds with 20. Illinois State winning 76-62. Shockers will get their payback and then some in February with a 41-point thrashing, evening up the season series. McIntosh was unavailable in that game, and here they stand now this afternoon in St. Louis with a 6-point early lead for Wichita State.
And this has become a really good rivalry, and the coaches talk about it, the players talk about it, and there's a little bit of an edge.
And why is it? Why? I know the conference foes and rivals, but have there been some things that have happened along the way?
You know, Wichita State has become the big dog, and everybody's pointing at them, and I think one of the reasons is Dan Muller's about as intense a guy as you will find. He was intense that way as a player. He coaches that way, and he recruits those kinds of kids. So it's just very interesting that 62 points that Wichita State scored in the first game, though, Kevin, that's one of only five times this year that they scored fewer than 75 points. So this is a very good offensive Shockers team.
Landry Shamit at the free throw line went to Park Hill High School, the highest rated recruit for Marshall. He was the Kansas City High School Player of the Year. His mom played volleyball at Boise. And Landry says that was a nice way to foul with her athleticism. Now carries that to the college basketball ranks. A redshirt freshman, a terrific young player. It's Clayton. He's picked up by Shamit. Clayton can drive, and he takes it inside. It's knocked away beautifully by Morris. Picked up by McDuffie. And it's out to Shamit the other way. Head is up and always looking down court for the open down.
And we talked about Wichita State's defense, obviously very solid that time.
Frankamp with a two and picked up by Injai.
Well, maybe that was his mistake. He was shooting from two.
Nice shot outside Wills, but he can't get it. Had a bit of space and got squared up on the play, and Frankamp the other way.
Boy, McDuffie is everywhere.
Mm. Consecutive wins for the Shockers. 14 consecutive and 8 straight for Illinois State coming into this championship game.
And the last game either one of them lost was to the other one.
Right. Inside with a good-looking drive. And Shamit's got six, and he's just given the Shockers their biggest lead this afternoon.
Shamit is a really tough guy to guard. He's big. He's 6 feet four. He's fairly quick with the basketball. He can shoot the three, so you have to respect that. And he does a nice job finishing when he gets close to the basket.
McIntosh takes it in, and there's McDuffie, and there's Morris. And they double him right there. They altered the shot. I don't think McDuffie could save it as it goes out of bounds. Illinois State's got the ball. Wednesday on CBS, 20 of the most legendary game changers in Survivor history return for a season like no other. Don't miss the premiere this Wednesday at 7 Central, 8 Eastern, only CBS. So Evans will inbound for the Redbirds, the number one seed for the first time in this tournament since 1998. In job.
That's the last time they went to the NCAA tournament.
It was with their head coach. Nice three outside put in by Parrish Lee.
Looks to me like the Redbirds have started out this game a little tight, but they'll loosen up once they see the ball go in the basket a couple times. Now here they've switched to the zone defense. Wichita State playing pretty well against the man-to-man, so they're changing pace right here.
Kelly with a screen, McDuffie with a three. And Kelly's got the ball. Great hustle by the Shockers. Here's McDuffie slithering down the lane and picked up inside. Grabbed by Clayton. Off to Lee. Little crossover move right there into two defenders. Hawkins back in, had the ball out of his hands. And a whistle and a foul on Wichita State. It goes on Kelly, who picks up his first for Wichita State.
Illinois State is not a team that's known for its running game, but they will get out and play in transition. They will take the opportunity break when it's available, and they really work the backboards in transition.
Look at Lee get in there, kind of find some room and across the lane with a little runner.
Well, he's keeping him in it right now.
He's got seven, and he averages 13. Under 13 to play in the first half.
Wichita State was doing a nice job getting it to the basket against the man-to-man. Let's see what they can do against the zone.
14-footer by Kelly No. Willis is in, gets the ball back to Frankamp. And they reset with another offensive rebound. Frankamp, triple.
Now, you don't want to leave him. That pass was made to Kelly on the outside. You leave him alone, you stay with Frankamp.
Frankamp now's at a couple threes, and that's 19 consecutive games with a three. The other end, Lee. Willis tries to grab it, and inside Clayton puts it up and in.
And Jai does a great job battling Willis, so Willis cannot control the ball. We talked about Illinois State being active on the boards. You see it once again. Those extra opportunities are going to be extremely important for them today.
Willis surprised how open he is, and the mid-range shot won't go. And Evans, he'll take it. Keyshawn Evans, Lee, triple. Kelly with the rebound. Kelly, one of the top players coming off the bench in the conference.
They consider him to be the energy guy. He goes in there and does all the dirty work. Oh, my.
McDuffie with a screen. Frankamp with a three. And trying to dig it out down low. As Darrell Willis Jr. was down there fighting for it. Then out of bounds. You're watching the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship with Connor Frankamp. Hitting a couple triples for the Shockers of Wichita State.
Make the world go around. And now try the flavor of hot honey mustard on the boneless wings meal. Served with crinkle fries, Texas toast, and a 22-ounce drink. Friends, family, flavor. Zaxby's. Indescribably good.
Tae-hyun, we gotta go. Come on.
Failure and success, life will ask, do you have steel courage? The greatest old spice shampoo ever. Huh. I say to life, impeccably smooth and great smelling hair is my middle name. It's an administrative nightmare.
Why do we snack? Because we have nothing better to do? Well, people who snack on almonds have something better to do. Almonds are heart healthy and full of energy, with the crunch that keeps you in the game. California Almonds. Crunch on.
Let's get it underway. Three core nuggets. Skywalker beyond belief.
March Madness, every game, every shot, every magic moment on CBS, TBS, TNT, and True TV. It all starts with the NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show. It's next Sunday, a special time of 5:30 Eastern, all the way to the Final Four and Championship game, only on CBS. With a look at some of the headlines, we're 7 days, 2 hours, 56 minutes away from Selection Sunday. But here are some headlines.
Well, everybody's talking about, will this be the year that Gonzaga finally breaks through to the Final Four? And, of course, that's an interesting question. We'll wait to see what happens. Northwestern, everybody thinks they're in the tournament. I remember there's only one team that's really in, and that's Jacksonville State at the moment. And then the Big East once put 11 teams in. A lot of people thought the ACC might break that record. Doesn't look like it's going to happen. But again, only Jacksonville State is in right at the moment.
Wichita State started this game 4-7 from the floor since they've gone 1-6. They bring in some new players like Deshaun Smith right here. He's a junior from Jacksonville, Florida.
Now this zone has made Wichita State jump shooters, and they haven't made very many of the jump shots. And Illinois State, they have 11 points. 9 of them are a result of offensive rebounds.
Drive here by Keller. Shot clock at 2. Frankamp with a 2. And the fly puts it down. He has been sensational. He's got 8 points.
And make no mistake about it, he is more than just a standstill jump shooter. He can shoot that ball off the dribble and in under pressure, as you showed you right there. That is a big play.
Evans over Frankamp. And that is a 3. Comes at a good time. Send it over to our sideline reporter, John Schiffen.
Well, in that last huddle, Coach Muller for Illinois State, his big concern on defense is finding Frankamp. He told his big guys, I don't care who's down low on a screen. You've got to get out. You've got to hedge. You have to know where he is at all times, guys.
Johnny's a good defensive coach. We know that. He was a two-time Missouri Valley Conference Defensive Player of the Year when he played in the late 90s. Lead of the 3. Shaq Morris reels it in. He's got a couple boards so far for the Shockers.
Well, the Redbirds made 13 three-point baskets yesterday. Shot the ball extremely well from out there. Not quite so hot today. But here's that zone that has slowed Wichita State down a little bit.
Smith thought about shooting. Brown dives and picked up by Phil Fain. McIntosh hits the deck hard. And he was whacked on the play and fouled by Morris. Frankamp has been tough.
Well, he's been the guy who's been most of the offense. He and Shamit for Wichita State early. He has knocked down 3 3-point baskets in the game, and he just hit a tough 2. But Dan Muller's absolutely right in telling his guys you can't leave him alone.
At the free throw line, Mikal McIntosh, a junior from Pickering, Ontario, Canada, whose honorable mention, Missouri Valley a season ago. He was injured in the loss to Wichita State, Dan, back in early February, February 4th. He missed 5 games, right knee injury, subsequent surgery, and then he was back. He's still not 100%, But it's a great story of coming back in season after knee surgery.
Well, I was able to talk to him yesterday, and he said he was feeling fine. And Dan Muller has been able to limit his minutes in this tournament. And so this is your third game in 3 days. Generally, you think a guy with a knee problem might have an issue, but McIntosh told me no, and Dan Muller told me no.
And they need his physicality this afternoon.
Yes, they do. If you look at them, they're long, but they're lean. Nearly as hefty as Wichita State.
Shannon put it up, and Kelly put on a screen, a rebound by the Redbirds, and here comes Lee.
Another jump shot against that zone, and that's exactly what Illinois State is trying to accomplish defensively.
A program record 27 wins and 17 in the regular season. Great drive inside. Lee couldn't get it. And corralled by Zach Brown of the Shockers.
Wichita State averages better than 80 points a game, Kevin, but they're not a team that looks to push it every single time. They try to run under control. What a catch inside. Good heavens.
Njai was there and looked like he fouled him. He did. David Njai picks up his second. Brackets are back. Get the CBS Sports app to play with friends and compete for prizes. Download it today and be ready when the field is set. Kevin Harlan, Dan Bonner, John Schriffen here in St. Louis. They call it Arch Madness. The Arch not too far from where we are.
Oh, this is a great tournament.
And a great city to have it in, too. It's been a great host, always has been, and continues this year.
Wichita State would like to get Shaquille Morris involved. We talked about him before the game, but he has yet to score. In fact, I don't think he's attempted a shot.
You might right here into Njai at 21 yesterday, and he comes up with two. Dan, you called it.
Well, when he gets the ball that close to the basket, he's just hard to contain.
His first two. Lee got the screen, and there's a whistle, and it's a foul, and it goes on the Shockers.
Well, that's a foul on McDuffie. Oh, here's inside. What a great job by Morris. And we talked before the game about what a great job he does getting position. And when you throw that ball anywhere close to him, he's going to catch it. He's got great hands.
So Illinois State have made the championship game 5 of the last 10 seasons, most in conference, but they've been 0-4 in their 4 previous appearances in the championship game, including 2 overtime losses.
Well, that's an illegal screen against Njai.
Njai picks it up, and he has come in the game not many minutes, and he's already got 3 fouls. They're going to take him out, and they're going to put back in Phil Fain, and they're going to take out Lee, and they're going to put in Keyshawn Evans.
Well, Fain has 2 fouls as well, and so this is a problem that Dan Muller was concerned about, whether or not his guys could stay out of foul trouble.
Shockers, their first Missouri Valley Conference Tournament Championship game appearance since 2014, which they won. Shannon Morris again, bulldozing.
And again, we said, think about the fact, he's 6'8", 265 pounds, but that was a pretty nimble movement to the goal. He's not just a back-to-the-basket guy.
McIntosh. And Deontay Hawkins, the top scorer. He puts up a 2, misses. There's Morris with the rebound. He's collected 4 for Wichita State. And Shannon the other way, and approaching 7.5 to play in the half. In that zone, Dan, that you talked about before. Screen by Kelly, Shannon on the fly.
And I think Hawkins got a piece of it.
I think he might have.
But one of the things they've been able to do, Kevin, is get the ball inside the last couple of possessions to Shaquille Morris. And as we've said, when he gets it inside, he's hard to stop. What a move.
In the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship.
Make the world go around. And now try the flavor of hot honey mustard on the boneless wings meal. Served with crinkle fries, Texas toast, and a 22-ounce drink. Friends, family, flavor. Zaxby's. Indescribably good.
Keep
the border of failure and success, life will ask, do you have steel courage, the greatest old spice shampoo ever? Huh, I say to life, impeccably smooth and great smelling hair is my middle name. It's an administrative nightmare.
Why do we snack? Because we have nothing better to do? Well, people who snack on almonds have something better to do. Almonds are heart healthy and full of energy, with the crunch that keeps you in the game. California almonds. Crunch on.
Camp has got the stroke for the Shockers. Lee is leading the Redbirds. Kevin Harlan alongside Dan Bonner here in St. Louis, Missouri. These two teams known for defense, too, so it's kind of interesting watching them feel each other out here.
Wow, those numbers that we just showed you are significant there. Neither team shooting the ball particularly well, but you saw 8 second chance points for Wichita State, 9 for Illinois State. So they're not shooting the ball well, but they're tracking it down and getting second opportunity.
They are indeed. The winner, of course, will get the automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. Selection Sunday, 2 weeks from today.
8 on the shot clock.
McDuffie 3. They got a hand on it. Hurdles his body out of bounds and saves it. And here come the Redbirds. A record season for them in every way.
And McDuffie, who made 3 3-point baskets yesterday, has yet to scratch from out there today.
Good feed. Got inside Morris, who shoves him and fouls him. And Phil Fain will go to the line as he got the great presence. And Morris picks up his second personal foul.
Well, Morris a little slow getting back after helping on that screen. And then he just puts both of his hands on Fain's back and pushes him. And that's 2 fouls on Shaquille Morris. And that's a blow for Wichita State because he was just getting hot.
Well, Fain is at the free throw line, a sophomore from Elk Grove, California, where he played at Franklin High School. He was a transfer from Western Nebraska College, as Morris will now sit out for the Shockers. We were talking before about the history of Illinois State. They were undefeated at home. They went 15-0 at home this season on Doug Collins Court. Yep, that Doug Collins, the 3-time All-America. He was the number one pick in the draft and played on the Olympic team. We just saw a note there about Northwestern. Doug's son, Chris, the coach of the Wildcats, and maybe the coach of the year in the Big Ten with a magnificent win last week over Michigan. But Doug Collins very involved in this program, and his name on the court of Illinois State. Nice spinner right there, put in. Good presence and a shot by Darrell Willis, the junior from Madison, Wisconsin.
Well, Willis is a guy who can score around the basket as well, and he's got a nice little left-handed jump shot. That's quite a weapon for Greg Marshall to be able to bring off the bench. You take Morris out and bring Willis in.
It sure is.
And Willis is a big, strong guy, too.
Illinois State shooting 31%. Wichita State 41% with a whistle. That is a foul, and it goes down low. It's on the Shockers. It's on Frankamp, who is a Wichita High School player. One of many terrific high school players to come out of the city of Wichita, beginning with Darnell Valentine. And there's a shot outside by Deontay Hawkins. That was a long three. He puts it in. The 9th leading score in the conference comes up with a beautiful triple.
And that's a big shot, I think, for Illinois State, just to sort of get them rolling a little bit. That gets the crowd involved in the game.
Shamit finds McDuffie. Now back to Shamit. And then Kelly will drive and feed. And Willis is right there with great position. But he can't convert. And Hawkins gets the ball. And it's out to Keyshawn Evans. Through traffic, accelerates, and throws to a trailer. And no one is home. You know, once you leap and you pass, you're in trouble. And he leapt and he passed and he was in trouble.
And if you look at Evans' stats, he's in there to shoot threes. He only has a few free throws on the year. He's not a guy. He probably got into unfamiliar territory. Thought, oh, what am I doing in here?
That's what you and I say every time we put on the headset. 5.5 to go. State Farm, Missouri Valley Conference Championship game here in St. Louis. And right through the grasp of Willis. With 5:27 to play tonight on 60 Minutes, protecting the king of the jungle. Meet a couple who have saved dozens and dozens of lions, plus a nautical mystery that lies deeper than the Titanic. Tonight, only CBS. So turnover right there. Only the second by Wichita State.
And Nerger comes in the game for Wichita State. This is a kid, 6'10", who was on the all-bench team. So they keep bringing all-MVC players off the bench.
Well, Nerger's had improved post play. That's helped out the Shockers significantly this season. A drive by Evans and out to McIntosh. She gives a thought and then drives inside and finds two right into Nerger.
That's the physical play you're talking about. He put that shoulder of his, did McIntosh, right into Nerger, bounced him away, and then was able to make the basket.
A one-time nine-point lead for the Shockers is down to three. Frank Camp on the floor. He has got the stroke this afternoon. 10 points for Wichita State.
Well, they're really glad they brought him.
Yeah, you act like maybe he forgot the time the bus was leaving. Oh, they go inside to Hawkins. Nice defensive play by Kelly.
Now, what when there was some team that was playing somewhere and they left their two leading scorers at the airport?
I saw that, yeah, the other day.
It has happened.
I know it. Nerger was driving.
They didn't leave Nerger either. No, he showed up.
Yeah, he did. McIntosh picks up his first. If Wichita State goes on to win, Dan, they'll win a 30th game for the fourth time in 5 years. And while their coach is in his 10th year, Greg Marshall has taken the team to the Final Four and built this program up. We're now in his nationally talked about, 21st in the country coming in this afternoon. He's had a lot of overtures to leave, and he's always decided to stay. Like we said before, one of the top 10 highest paid coaches in college basketball.
He is an excellent coach, and he's got a real good feel for his community and for his team. And it was funny, we were talking to him about life without Van Fleet and Baker, and he said he didn't know what to do. They went on a trip to Canada. They didn't play very well, and he thought they were going to be really bad. They might not win 20 games. So that's his standard. You know, saying, well, we might be really bad. We might only win 4 or 5 games. Well, no, his standard is 20.
It is.
And 20's a bad year.
Fred Van Vliet, Ron Baker. Legendary players in the history of this Wichita State program. McIntosh with a spinner. Trying to go in and a foul on the play.
And that's two fouls on McDuffie.
Yep.
And I think that's really where Illinois State needs to go. They need to attack Wichita State. You don't want to force things when you get inside, but when you attack, you create foul problems, you put your opponent in difficult situations. And McIntosh, big and strong as we have discussed, has been able to do that effectively.
So here's McIntosh at the line. You know, Dan Muller is the fifth-year coach and the conference coach of the year in the Missouri Valley. He played at Illinois State, played in a couple of NCAAs. He's the 11th all-time leading scorer. A two-time Valley Defensive Player of the Year. Played in Belgium and Argentina and for a cup of coffee in the NBA, and he was a Vanderbilt assistant coach to Kevin Stallings for 12 years, and in the Southeastern Conference, established himself as a great recruiter. Now he comes home and leads this program to their best season since 98.
And clearly, he's an outstanding defensive coach, and that's interesting because most coaches you talk to, when they talk about Kevin Stallings, they talk about what a gifted offensive coach he is, so they must have made a great combination.
Austin Reeves has come in.
Reeves is the guy who's in there looking to shoot the three.
Patience by Wichita State. The zone stays intact for the Redbirds. Frank Camp, he's outside for the fire. And a three will not make it. And Reeves can't get it, but Willis does. And Wills will feed up court. Lee is in and thinks about the triple. The conference player of the year into three defenders. Wills into Reeves. The pump, the drive, the offensive foul.
That's a great job by Reeves moving his feet. Wills looked like he had a lane to the basket.
When a tournament bid is on the line, the emotion, the passion runs high. Regardless of the venue, regardless of the conference, you're watching college basketball on CBS.
Chipotle's royal ingredients have gathered for a most noble cause. They were seasoned and grilled, hand-pampered and thrilled, hence the chorus of oohs and ahs.
the border of failure and success, life will ask, do you have steel courage, the greatest old spice shampoo ever? Huh, I say to life, impeccably smooth and great smelling hair is my middle name. It's an administrative nightmare.
Type 2 diabetes? Listen up. We're not professional athletes, but that doesn't mean we're giving up.
I'm in this for me.
For me.
Along with diet and exercise, Farxiga helps lower blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes, lowering A1C by up to 1.2 points.
Do not take if allergic to Farxiga. If you experience symptoms of a serious allergic reaction, such as rash, swelling, difficulty breathing or swallowing, stop taking and seek medical help right away. Do not take Farxiga if you have severe kidney problems, are on dialysis, or have bladder cancer. Tell your doctor right away if you have blood or red color in your urine, or pain while you urinate. Farxiga can cause serious side effects, including dehydration, genital yeast infections in women and men, serious urinary tract infections, low blood sugar, and kidney problems. Stop taking Farxiga and call your doctor right away if you have signs of ketoacidosis, which is serious and may lead to death.
I'm in this for my family.
I'm in this for me.
Ask your doctor about Farxiga and learn how you can get it for free.
At the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship game, a look at the Shocker Band and all these conference championship games coming up. Already got one team in, Jacksonville State, Patriot League Championship game, middle of this week, Wednesday. And next week we got the big major conferences. Dan, you'll be doing some ACC work, the Southeastern Conference, Pac-12, Big 12, Big 10. I mean, they're all over the country and deciding who will be in the group of 68.
Neither team's really been able to get into a rhythm offensively, Kevin. I think the defenses have been pretty good. I think that these teams understand what's at stake here, so maybe everybody's just a little bit tight here. And foul trouble has complicated things for both teams.
Yes, it has. Reeves is weaving. Framkamp is firing.
And that's right in front of Dan Muller, and he's the defense. He was the two-time defensive player of the year. You could think maybe he wanted to block the shot because he was the only guy anywhere close. And John said that he told these guys, don't leave him.
Hawkins triple. That won't go. It's collected by Wills. Willis gets it and gives it off to Reeves, and now back to Framkamp, who's got 13. He's got three triples so far with 2.5 to go in the half here in St. Louis. Mercer a screen. Shamit with the run.
Oh, what a play.
What
by
a
Willis.
Play. Willis, my goodness, did he get high. Biggest lead for the Shockers.
And this is a very big Wichita State lineup right at the moment against a relatively small Illinois State lineup. Need a basket here.
He's got 7 points. 1-3, but he's 3 of 9. McIntosh with a triple. Reeves with the rebound.
Illinois State has stayed in that zone.
There's a screen, Nerger. He is screening out Lee, and Reeves is firing from the wing. We told you before.
Well, what you've got, look right here. That's the guy you want to watch here. And as this play develops, just watch what Framkamp does. He just wanders out there. He's standing right in front of Dan Muller. All the defenders go the other way. You cannot leave Framkamp, and certainly not today.
He had 18 yesterday against Missouri State. He had 6 threes in that 18-point performance in the semifinals. Lee, 3 over Framkamp. Rebound, B.J. Clayton, but dug away nicely inside by Darrell Willis. And out of bounds, and it's off of Wichita State.
Well, the fans are upset, but there was no jump ball called there, so that means the referee ruled that Willis had possession of the ball, and when you take a couple of steps with possession of the ball, and you're not playing in the NBA All-Star game, that's called a traveling violation.
He's tried by Lee, but he can't convert. And his afternoon is only 30%, 3 of 10 from the floor.
I don't know how that ball didn't go in the basket.
He's missed six straight shots. Shannon's good with the ball. Good hand of it is Brown. Good feed. Shannon. We have a minute to go. Mercer will try to carve his way, surrounded by defenders. Good rebound by Brown. Hawkins then picks it up and takes it away. And the Redbirds the other way. The number one seed, a 27-5 team. Evans driving right into Mercer. And Hawkins couldn't hold on to it. And the shot clock is at 20. Well, coming up in the AT&T at the half, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, Seth Davis will have highlights from the Ohio Valley Conference Championship game. Jacksonville State became the first team to punch the ticket. Also on tap, a visit from the Basketball Selection Committee Chair, Mark Hollis, one of the terrific men in college basketball. He'll detail the committee's busy week ahead. The AT&T at the half next on CBS from New York. Mills, Lee, triple. Got it! And they needed that. At least trying to hang their head on something positive. 18 seconds to go. Timeout taken by Wichita State. They've led by as many as 11.
The ingredients here at Chipotle are the finest in all of the land. So at their request, we threw them a fest to honor their flavors so grand.
Like, really good.
They insisted we prepare them by hand, as we showered them with seasoning and praise. Entertaining and marinating, sauteing and celebrating, 'twas truly the most delicious of...
It is an 8-point lead for Wichita State in a game that has been dominated by defense. And normally, you would think that would create an advantage for Illinois State. But don't forget that Wichita State is a top defensive team as well. Paris Lee, who just hit that 3-point basket, has struggled a little bit from the floor. They've had some foul trouble, have the Redbirds. And Connor Frankamp for Wichita State has done a great job knocking down big shots.
Two very good defensive teams. Illinois State number 4 in field goal defense, and Wichita State number 5 in field goal defense. That is in all of college basketball. Reeves, final seconds. The trap, Mercer going inside, knocked away by Clayton. And if it goes, it will not count, and there we go. So Wichita State, if they go on to win, will be in their 6th consecutive NCAA tournament. That would tie a Missouri Valley Conference record. And in this historical season for the Redbirds of Illinois State, trying to get into the tournament with a win for the first time since 1998. To John Shriffin.
Thank you. Coach, you went on a little run near the end of the half. What did you do differently to finish the half out strong?
Made shots. We didn't do anything differently. They were man-to-man the first couple of minutes. Then they go to their zone. I thought we attacked it pretty well. Connor got some good looks. We got the ball inside until we bobbled one. Daryl Willis should have laid it in, and then he lost one between his legs. Shaq got a few down around the basket. Other than that, I think we got some stops and got some, we didn't get any transition. They were beating us down the floor. We'll have to address that at halftime.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
Thanks.
Greg Marshall, he says, we feel like we've been in the postseason for 5 or 6 weeks already. Now we're going to take you to New York in our CBS studios and hand it off to Greg Gumbel for the AT&T at the half.
Make the world go around. And now try the flavor of hot honey mustard on the boneless wings meal. Served with crinkle fries, Texas toast, and a 22-ounce drink. Friends, family, flavor. Zaxby's. Indescribably good.
At the border of failure and success, life will ask, do you have steel courage? The greatest old spice shampoo ever? Huh. I say to life, impeccably smooth and great-smelling hair is my middle name. It's an administrative nightmare.
Type 2 diabetes? Listen up. We're not professional athletes, but that doesn't mean we're giving up.
I'm in this for me.
For me.
Along with diet and exercise, Farxiga helps lower blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes, lowering A1C by up to 1.2 points.
Do not take if allergic to Farxiga. If you experience symptoms of a serious allergic reaction, such as rash, swelling, difficulty breathing or swallowing, stop taking and seek medical help right away. Do not take Farxiga if you have severe kidney problems, are on dialysis, or have bladder cancer. Tell your doctor right away if you have blood or red color in your urine, or pain while you urinate. Farxiga can cause serious side effects, including dehydration, genital yeast infections in women and men, serious urinary tract infections, low blood sugar, and kidney problems. Stop taking Farxiga and call your doctor right away if you have signs of ketoacidosis, which is serious and may lead to death.
I'm in this for my family.
I'm in this for me.
Ask your doctor about Farxiga and learn how you can get it for free.
Why do we snack? Because we have nothing better to do? Well, people who snack on almonds have something better to do. Almonds are heart healthy and full of energy, with the crunch that keeps you in the game. California almonds. Crunch on.
different flavors make the world go around. And now try the flavor of hot honey mustard on the boneless wings meal. Served with crinkle fries, Texas toast, and a 22-ounce drink. Friends, family, flavor. Zaxby's. Indescribably good.
What powers the digital world? Communication. That's why a cutting-edge university counts on CenturyLink to keep their global campus connected. And why a pro football team chose us to deliver fiber-enabled broadband to more than 65,000 fans. And why a leading car brand counts on us to keep their dealer network streamlined and nimble. Businesses count on communication, and communication counts on CenturyLink. CenturyLink, your link to what's next.
At the border of failure and success, life will ask, do you have steel courage, the greatest old spice shampoo ever? Huh, I say to life, impeccably smooth and great smelling hair is my middle name. It's an administrative nightmare.
We're led to believe each individual point is worth the same amount, regardless of when it's scored. Layups are always worth 2 points, theoretically. But fans know that's not the case, because here, in the last minute, everything counts for just a little bit more. Under 30 seconds, three-pointers tend to feel like five. As for buzzer beaters, they're worth the whole shebang.
Go-to is USAA. Everyone knows that, especially everyone in the military. Even though I'm out of the military, they refer to me as my rank. It shows that USAA serves as military members, and I'm part of that community that they serve.
Why do we snack? Because we have nothing better to do? Well, people who snack on almonds have something better to do. Almonds are heart healthy and full of energy, with the crunch that keeps you in the game.
The State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship on CBS is sponsored by Buick with 7 expectation-shattering models. Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. Reese's. Perfect. And by AT&T. Litany of big names in the history of the Valley. As we take a look at the State Farm first half stats, Dan Bonner.
We said defense dominated the first half. Interestingly, though, not very many free throws. The points off turnovers, Illinois State only had one more than Wichita State, but Wichita State obviously did a great job converting them, and that, you can boil the story of the first half down right there.
You can see the numbers right there moments ago. Illinois State head coach Dan Muller to his team in their locker room at halftime.
If you played a great half, keep your head up. If you played a bad half, keep your head up. Do not let anything affect you, right? Whatever noise you're hearing, crowd, whatever, negative, whatever, you just stay focused on chopping wood. That's it. That's it, fellas. That's it. We're not trying to play to win a championship. We're just trying to play that one possession perfect right there. That's it. Okay? We do that. We just chip away a little bit, a little more solid. We're good to go. Okay? Let's go, guys.
Let's go, y'all. Well, the winner advances here. We know that, Dan Bonner. And you don't want to leave anything to chance. So a win makes it solid. A loss, you got to wait.
Yeah, makes it for a long week. And you heard Dan Muller say they can't be worried about what the final score is right now. What they've got to do is chip away one possession at a time. You know, use the old cliche. But that's exactly what has to be done. They've got to take a little bit better care of the basketball. And I think they have to continue trying to take and attack the basket.
Here we go, and Wichita State is up or tied at halftime. They are 26-0. Hawkins, no. Willis, the rebound. He's got five for the Shockers. Shamit Willis. Zach Brown out there with the ball now. Shamit.
And Wichita, Illinois State stays in the zone. Shaq Morris starts on the bench with those two fouls.
Framkamp. Shamit, open triple.
Those two guys are really good three-point shooters. You know, Framkamp has been the guy who's been dominating this tournament, but Shamit throughout the year has been every bit as solid. That's a pick-your-poison kind of thing there.
Shamit's got a couple threes. Framkamp has three of them. go inside. Thane. Leola, dribbling violation. Carried the ball.
This is just a nice job getting in, drawing the defense, and then Frankap, who had the open shot, gives it up, and Shamit knocks down a wide open one. Shamit has actually struggled a little bit from 3-point to 3.9 in the tournament, only 2 for 8 coming into this game.
Shamit, the second leading scorer, leading assist man, top free throw percentage shooter on the Shocker team. It comes in number 21 in college basketball, second seed in this tournament, 29-4. Willis, biggest lead for Wichita State.
That's his power inside. Very little that Illinois State can do about that if they're going to get it that close.
It was a whistle. It was a shove inside. It was a foul. It's on the Shockers with 18:25 to go here in the second half. With a look at Zach Brown. Brown picks up his first.
And that was created by Paris Lee attacking the basket.
So Wills is out there. Hawkins with the ball here. McIntosh. The drive for the Redbirds. Gets his own miss. Up again. Knocked away inside. Willis had the rejection for the Shockers and comes out of the pack with it.
That whole play started with some great defense by Shamit to knock the ball out of the hands of McIntosh, who appeared to have an open lane to the basket.
Shamit with a steady little mid-range shot. Won't go. Lee clutches onto the ball.
And they went back to the man-to-man that time, and Shamit thought he could take Lee under the basket, but a really good defensive sequence by the defensive player of the year.
Number one seeded Redbirds of Illinois State, 27-5. Coach Hans, ooh, a drive inside by Lee, and he came down hard. With the bounce, he's a tough kid on that left arm. With a foul called inside. 17:41 to go. Brown has picked up his second foul in this second half.
You get the idea, Kevin, that this kid hit the free throw line. Paris Lee is just trying to will his team to get back in this game. He's been in attack mode the entire afternoon.
CBS Sports Network's biggest bracket week ever is underway with 3 conference championships in 6 days and late round games from tournaments all over the country. Don't miss any of the action all week long in the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Paris Lee from Proviso East High School in Maywood, Illinois. Most starts in the history of the Illinois State program. And began the broadcast talking about him, the Larry Bird Player of the Year in the conference, the Defensive Player of the Year. And he's decorated the player as there is in this league. With a little shove right there, Tony Wills has picked up his second for the Redbirds.
And Wills is another guy who's on the first team all-defensive team in the Missouri Valley Conference, and he was just trying to put some pressure on the basketball, but he's a senior. He needs to be more patient than that.
John Schifrin is on our sideline.
Well, I spoke to Coach Miller at the half. He told me because of the foul trouble, they had to rely on the zone a lot in that first half. Now that they had all their men, look, they're in man. They're switching things up, and they're trying to get out of that zone because Frankamp basically shot them out of it.
John, thank you. Kelly. Morris has just come in. Kelly with a good series of moves. Morris had a hand on it, but DJ Clayton comes up with it.
That looked like the ball just slipped out of Kelly's hands. He did everything but put it in the basket.
Lee, 3, off. He's 4 of 13.
On their feint is going to pick up another foul, trying to battle against Morris inside, and that has been a real struggle for Phil Fain today. And Dan Muller told us yesterday that his biggest concern was his key guys getting in foul trouble, and that's what we've seen so far today.
Redbirds beat Wichita State in Normal back in mid-January, then lost at Wichita in early February. Gone at it, splitting the season and splitting the conference. Co-league champions, both at 17-1.
They have Injai back in the game.
He had some foul problems.
Well, he's got 3, Fane's got 3. The guy who comes out of the game is Hawkins. I think they're concerned that now that they're in the man-to-man, they're going to try, Wichita State is going to try to get the ball inside to Morris.
Frankamp will take it in with a spinner. Nice move inside, Connor Frankamp.
Well, we said in the first half, Kevin, he's more than just a jump shooter. He's really been good today.
He's got 15 points, leading scorer. Lee, right down the lane.
At the moment, that is the Illinois State offense. They've got to get some other guys firing a little bit, but Paris Lee doing everything he can to keep them in the game.
Shaq Morris, he was on the doorstep, couldn't make it go. Rebound by Fain, and the other way they send Lee. Beats the trap, throws it high, looking for Fain, caught by Lee.
The ingredients here at Chipotle are the finest in all of the land. So at their request, we threw them a fest to honor their flavors so grand.
Like, really good.
They insisted we prepare them by hand, as we showered them with seasoning and praise. Entertaining and marinating, sauteing and celebrating, 'twas truly the most delicious of days.
Of automatic bids already decided. The Ohio Valley Conference has their team in Jacksonville State. The Big South will have Winthrop. The third will be decided in a little less than 16 minutes here of game time from the Missouri Valley Conference. Greg Marshall at Winthrop. He was the head coach before he took over at Wichita State. Helped transform the Eagles into a perennial mid-major powerhouse with Winthrop. Seven NCAA tournament appearances in his nine seasons as the head coach of the program. And there is his resume with his Shockers. They come in number 21 in the top 25.
We talked about this earlier, Kevin. This is a team that has just simply won and won and won. They have very few opportunities against top 50 teams, most of them in November, December. Remember, they were trying to put a new team together without Baker, without Van Fleet. And so as you can see there, our guy Jerry Palm has them out if they lose this game.
Lee at the line, missing right there. Lee's got 16 points. The rest of Illinois State, 15. Lee's got six field goals. The rest of the team, five. Lee's got a couple of assists. The rest of the team, one. He's been a one-man show, obviously. Fran Camp taken away by Lee. With Shamit defending. Oh, what a play. Fain could not get it. Down hard he goes. Save in the corner. Redbirds have it. Fain is wobbly, and here is Lee with a whistle. Injury timeout. Fain is down. He came down hard.
There's a couple of great defensive plays in this sequence leading up to Fain being hurt. Shamet does a great job getting back and getting hold of the ball, and then he just grabs onto the rim and sort of loses his balance. I'm not sure the crowd is booing here. I'm not sure there's any reason to boo, and that's the problem. He goes straight down. He's not nobody underneath him for support. He doesn't get a chance to put his arms out to catch his fall.
And that left knee, he was holding on to his knee when he came down.
Still favoring that left knee.
Yeah, he is. He's the seventh leading rebounder in the conference. He's sixth in block shots. So we know his value. And with the game the way it is, they can hardly afford to lose someone like Phil Fink. Had 11 rebounds in the game against Southern Illinois yesterday and 6 points. A couple blocks, 3 assists.
He and Connor Frankamp are just going up for the basketball, and you're right, that it is the left knee. He catches that left knee just awkwardly. It looked like it buckled on him. And he is in real pain.
Keyshawn Evans in there with Lee. Clayton, can you save it? He did. Njai trying to set his screen. Has a foul. Morris up top. That is number 3.
And that's exactly the kind of foul that your big guy cannot commit. Particularly your big guy who's got a couple of fouls. If you're going to get a foul, maybe trying to block a shot or something like that. But here, he just steps on the screen and puts his hip right into Paris Lee. And give Lee some credit, too. I've always thought a guard coming off that screen, if he sees a big guy jumping out there, just drive the ball right into the hip of the big guy. He'll get a foul every time.
Lee inside. Injai can't get the reverse. Frankamp comes up with it. Out of bounds.
I think Njai just committed a foul, too. That'd be number 4.
He did. Number 4 for Njai. And that is an issue.
Not a lot of activity and not a lot of offense for the last couple of possessions.
Frankamp gets a Kelly screen. Lee sticks right with him. Berger is coming, as we said. It's Kelly into Hawkins. Shamet triple.
And that's the way they play, inside out. Lots of times they throw it into the post. That time Kelly just drove the ball into the middle. The defense collapsed, and Shamet has made a couple of threes here in the second half, has started to get hot.
And 3 of 4 from beyond the arc in this contest for the Shockers. Top scorer, Hawkins, this season for the Redbirds. Can't get it. Kelly with the ball. Coast to coast. Takes it in. Great rejection by Njai. And here comes Lee the other way for Illinois State. And Shannon will meet him. The number 1 seeded Redbirds with the ball. Clayton triple. Njai's got the ball. Mercer was there, and he curls right around him and gets it to go. Njai, the sophomore from Dakar, Senegal, with a timeout taken by Illinois State. A 10-point lead for Wichita State.
The ingredients here at Chipotle are the finest in all of the land. So at their request, we threw them a fest to honor their flavors so grand.
Like, really good.
They insisted we prepare them by hand, as we showered them with seasoning and praise. Entertaining and marinating, sauteing and celebrating, 'twas truly the most delicious of days.
Type 2 diabetes? Listen up. We're not professional athletes, but that doesn't mean we're giving up.
I'm in this for me.
For me.
Along with diet and exercise, Farxiga helps lower blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes, lowering A1C by up to 1.2 points.
Do not take if allergic to Farxiga. If you experience symptoms of a serious allergic reaction, such as rash, swelling, difficulty breathing, or swallowing, stop taking and seek medical help right away. Do not take Farxiga if you have severe kidney problems, are on dialysis, or have bladder cancer. Tell your doctor right away if you have blood or red color in your urine or pain while you urinate. Farxiga can cause serious side effects, including dehydration, genital yeast infections in women and men, serious urinary tract infections, low blood sugar, and kidney problems. Stop taking Farxiga and call your doctor right away if you have signs of ketoacidosis, which is serious and may lead to death.
I'm in this for my family.
I'm in this for me.
Ask your doctor about Farxiga and learn how you can get it for free.
Go to is USAA. Everyone knows that, especially everyone in the military. Even though I'm out of the military, they refer to me as my rank. It shows that USAA serves as military members and I'm part of that community that they serve.
Back in St. Louis, the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship, the Late Show with Stephen Colbert is America's Choice. Tomorrow, Stephen's All New with Anderson Cooper and Judd Apatow. Colbert, All New, all this week on CBS. The lead is 10 for Wichita State. Let's talk about Illinois State. The number one seed coming in, co-winners of the regular season. They've won 8 straight, 19 of 21. Their RPI is 26. They have not played a top 25 team this season until today, number 21 Wichita State.
And that 1-1 against the top 50, that is against Wichita State. And as we said, the Missouri Valley down a little bit this year, and therefore they have a tough time with the strength of schedule. But again, this is a very, very good basketball team. They have struggled today, though. It's interesting. Lee has 16 points. Nobody else has more than 5, and now they're trying to pick up the defense.
Look at McIntosh diving on the floor and going for those loose balls. Terrific play. They have not won the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament. Illinois State hasn't since 98. That was the last season, as we mentioned before. They went to the NCAA Tournament. Janet tries to bust it. Trapped to Frankamp. Hold on. Mercer inside. Double. Great defense. Oh, McDuffie! What a play by McDuffie. He finished right in back of Paris Lee. In terms of votes in the Missouri Valley Conference, Player of the Year.
That's McDuffie's first field goal of the game.
Big drive here, Clayton across the lane with little resistance.
Well, little is a very...
being nice.
Yeah, that's a glass half full kind of thing. There's nobody there, and the Wichita State coaching staff reacted very badly to that.
Janet throws by Rills, down low. McIntosh was defending McDuffie, and a foul goes on McIntosh. John Shriffin has an update on the injury.
Well, some good news for Illinois State. Phil Fain is back on the bench. They took him back into the locker room. The team doctor took a look at him. They ran him through a series of tests. I watched as he made cuts and he was jumping up and down, touching the ceiling. They think he is okay to go. It's a knee sprain right now. He's on the bench. They're going to see if they put him back in, guys.
Thank you, John. They need him. But we'll have to see with now just under 13 to play in this game. Mercer. With a spin right there, the defense by Deontay Hawkins, and a foul. It was called down low. McIntosh was there defending, and he picks up his third. Mercer playing a lot because Shaq Morris has foul problems for the Shockers.
Kevin McIntosh went down to help, and he got there too late. If he could have helped while Mercer was dribbling the basketball, generally the official will let you make that play. But once Mercer picks up the ball and starts his move to the basket, the official is almost never going to let you knock it out of his hands without calling a foul.
Mercer at the stripe. He played some of his best minutes last season in the NCAA tournament for the Shockers. He's a junior from Estonia, who originally committed to Ole Miss. They had a coaching change, and so they let him out of the commitment, and he plays for Wichita State and Coach Greg Marshall. Winningest coach in the history of the program. Final 4-13, the Sweet 16 a couple years ago, and 4 outright conference titles in the last 6 years.
Hawkins is trying to post up Shamet inside, and they missed the mismatch.
Evans looking, probing, Hawkins, a 3.
See, it's not a mismatch in favor of Illinois State out there. Shamet did a nice job forcing him to the corner.
Mills gets on McDuffie.
Got to tighten it up on the defensive end here. Got to get some stops, obviously, and get your crawl to be able to crawl back into the game.
Look at Frampton crawl down the lane with a good rebound by Paris Lee. He's got five. McIntosh triple. Big shot here and a miss. Rebound by Kelly.
Just have not been able to make any of those, Kevin. They've had a couple of opportunities, but that big shot that looks like it would be the momentum changer just won't go in the basket for them.
They're 4-16. Wichita State 6-14. Mercer, Kelly.
That is a big time rebound.
It
right
is.
There.
Mercer was shoved. Out of bounds it goes. And a timeout with 11:41, make it 11:36 to go here in St. Louis.
Different flavors make the world go around. And now try the flavor of hot honey mustard on the boneless wings meal. Served with crinkle fries, Texas toast, and a 22-ounce drink. Friends, family, flavor. Zaxby's. Indescribably good.
Type 2 diabetes? Listen up. We're not professional athletes, but that doesn't mean we're giving up.
I'm in this for me.
For me.
Along with diet and exercise, Farxiga helps lower blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes, lowering A1C by up to 1.2 points.
Do not take if allergic to Farxiga. If you experience symptoms of a serious allergic reaction, such as rash, swelling, difficulty breathing or swallowing, stop taking and seek medical help right away. Do not take Farxiga if you have severe kidney problems, are on dialysis, or have bladder cancer. Tell your doctor right away if you have blood or red color in your urine, or pain while you urinate. Farxiga can cause serious side effects, including dehydration, genital yeast infections in women and men, serious urinary tract infections, low blood sugar, and kidney problems. Stop taking Farxiga and call your doctor right away if you have signs of ketoacidosis, which is serious and may lead to death.
I'm in this for my family.
I'm in this for me.
Ask your doctor about Farxiga and learn how you can get it for free.
The process through USAA is so effortless that you feel like you're a part of the family.
I love that I can pass a membership to my children and that they can be protected. We're the Williams family and we're USAA members for life.
The State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship on CBS is sponsored by Mercedes-Benz, the best or nothing. Verizon, join a better network because better matters. And by State Farm, talk to an agent today at 800-STATE-FARM. Wichita State is led by as many as 13. Illinois State has not led, no ties and no lead changes. Coming up next, a big one from the Big Ten. The Northwestern Wildcats against number 16 Purdue. Two great stories in that terrific conference. And a lot of people think, with the win over Michigan a week ago, that Northwestern is in. What do you think?
You know, they have a really good record. You see 21-9 overall in a conference like the Big Ten. You see wins over Dayton at Wisconsin. That is a big win. And then you talked about that Michigan win, and they have four wins against top 50 teams. So they have played very well in one of the really fine conferences in the country, and you'd think that they would get in, but like everybody else, except for Winthrop and Jacksonville State, nobody's sure. Gotta keep winning games.
Automatic bid is such a big deal. Tony Wills is back in for Illinois State. Good drive inside Lee. Oh, that was spectacular. He has done it all. 16, make it 18 points. Five rebounds, a couple of assists. He's the only player for the Redbirds in double figures.
And this is just he just makes an aggressive drive to the basket. This is how he has scored a lot of his points. They're not helping off on the drive because of what a great passer he is. They don't want him to get going from three-point range, but if he makes this free throw, he will have exactly half of the Illinois State points.
That's tough to win with that, though, when it's all on one player. He's the fourth all-time leading assist man at Illinois State, all-time steals leader. He's been so valuable for this program, the senior Paris Lee, player of the year in the conference. His defense, impeccable, and he's now on Shamit.
They've gotten a couple of stops here. Now they've got to get some more stops and some more conversions.
How about Willis with that spin as he goes in on Fain, who, by the way, just came back in. That's good to see. John Schriffen just gave us that update. Fain, though, picks up his fourth.
And that was a difficult play for Fain because Willis was off balance. I'm not sure Willis could have even gotten that ball to the rim. And Fain, trying to play tough defense, commits the foul.
At the free throw line, the junior from Madison, Wisconsin, Memorial High School, Darryl Willis. He was All-State in that state of Wisconsin, Pearl River, Mississippi Community College, a third-team junior college All-America. And now with the Shockers.
And he has really been a big force for Wichita State today. He's got 8.7 rebounds, three block shots, and that's with Shaquille Morris in foul trouble.
That's a three. Evans can't get it. Look at Fain just leaping out of the rafters, but he throws it away. And it goes now to Deshaun Smith, who drives and hits the deck hard and is fouled on the play. He was at that point, and he brought in Shamit, and that kind of changed the season. Evans picks up his first.
That was one of the moves that you make during the season. We talked about the fact that Wichita State was trying to get the backcourt situation squared away, losing Fred Van Fleet and Ron Baker. And so, obviously, you're going to have to tinker a little bit early in the season, and moving Shamit to the point guard was the thing that got them really rolling.
At the first to go, Wichita State, 29-4. Co-conference champions, a share of the title for a fourth consecutive season. And for the fifth time in 6 years, they're on top. Eight consecutive 25-win seasons. And if they get to 30, it'll be the fourth time in 5 years. They're closing in on it right now.
And one of the things that this team does very well is shoot free throws. And so it's going to be really difficult for Illinois State if Wichita State is going to be able to get to the line and convert.
Lee by Brown to the hole. Fran Kemp comes up with it. He's hit his threes. He leads him in scoring, and he brings it down court and gets it off to Smith. He's picked up by Evans and screened by Willis. Outside, McDuffie three. Fouled as he shot by Hawkins. So three at the line. Hawkins picks up his second for the Redbirds. Number one seed for the first time since 98.
You mentioned McDuffie has really struggled today, and that's interesting. McDuffie, who was outstanding yesterday, has struggled. Jack Morris, who was outstanding yesterday, has struggled, and yet guys have come off the bench for Wichita State and have performed very well, and the Shockers have one of the best benches in the country. I think number two in the country in terms of bench scoring behind the Citadel.
Well, as Greg Marshall was telling us last night, this is our best offensive team since I've been here. And they had Van Vliet, and they had Baker. They've had a lot of good players along the way.
When we were able to talk to the players yesterday, Shaq Morris told us, you know, if one of us is having a bad game, somebody else is going to have a good game. And that they really pride themselves on picking each other up out there on the court. And certainly that's what we've seen today.
Look at Shamit's leg there, Mike. Mike Arnold, our director, got a shot of it. Here's more full court pressure by the Shockers. It's saved by Smith. Did he go out of bounds? Let's see. The officials rule, and Wichita State will get.
Smith didn't go out of bounds, but Clayton, who was trying to save it for Illinois State, did go out of bounds. And now we've got double technicals. One technical was called on Willis. I'm not sure whether the other one was on McIntosh or Hawkins, but they just lit up two guys.
May have been Hawkins.
That's Paul Jansen over discussing this with the official score.
When you look at Wichita State, so physical, Dan. They're long, they're big. I mean, they've got all the components of a team that you'd expect to see play in the March.
I think that's one of the reasons why with this team, with their depth, with their strength, and particularly their physical nature, their ability to make shots, I think they could play in any of the big conferences and play very successfully. On the left of your screen, Willis and Hawkins just run into one another. Now that's interesting. Willis looked to me like he was much more sinned against than sinning there. But remember, we said these teams don't like one another, and the officials are well aware of that, and they're trying to jump on that early before it becomes a problem. But that looked to me like that was all Hawkins.
Good view of that from our producer, Kenny Mack, and under 10 to play, just by the halfway part of the second half. A lot of talk about going into quarters in college basketball, like in every other level of basketball, with a move right here, past the lane, General Willis Jr. making a move, hit the deck, and another foul.
And what you see happening now is Wichita State is just starting to grind them up. They're taking the ball inside, both with the pass and the dribble. They're forcing Illinois State into fouling situations, and so far, at least, the Shockers have been able to go to the line and make free throws.
Fain has picked up his fifth.
And that has
finished.
That's been a problem the entire game. He picked up two really early fouls, had to come out of the game, and Phil Fain, this is a guy who's a tremendous rebounder, the leader in field goal percentage shooting in the Missouri Valley Conference, really has hurt that he has not been able to perform up to his normal levels because of foul trouble.
So McIntosh is in, Wills is in, Hawkins is in, Lee at the point, Njai, that's the five for the Redbirds. And at the free throw line is Darryl Willis for the Shockers. He's out there with Smith and Frankamp, Brown, McDuffie. Wichita State, Dan Bonner, is an 8-0 run right now.
Illinois State just can't get the ball to go in the basket. And some of that credit goes to the Wichita State defense. And there is an offensive foul now. Hawkins just trying to force it.
So Hawkins moments ago with Willis picked up those technical fouls. Hawkins has picked up one more. He's got four.
Well, he just lowers his shoulder and blasts away. McDuffie in really good position, and that's right in front of the official.
So they got to save Hawkins, so he'll hit the bench. And here's Keyshawn Evans on the ball handler. Deshaun Smith, the junior from Jacksonville.
And with all the foul trouble, Illinois State forced to drop back into that zone.
Smith works on Evans, shot clock at 7. Frank Hill, lead defense, conference defensive player of the year. They've gotten a hand on it, nice defense right there. And here come the Redbirds. McIntosh, Evans. Jack tried to run to the rim, and he was met there by Willis. Lee shifting gears, triple team, no good. And the little guy gets it, Evans. Pump fake and opens up the triple. That's no good. The shooting has just been absent all game long from three for Illinois State. 4 of 18, overall 30%, Dan. And they just have not found their mark this afternoon with the foul right there going on Willis of the Shockers, his second.
Kevin, and that's really interesting because in the first half of yesterday's game against Southern Illinois,
they're unbelievable.
Well, they could miss from beyond the three-point arc. And that's what Dan Muller told us, that they were very hot from out beyond three.
They beat Southern Illinois yesterday by 13.
And they were 9 for 15 from beyond the arc in the first half yesterday. And
every time you looked up, they were hitting the shot, weren't they? Yeah.
They haven't been able to duplicate that. And part of that, again, is the Wichita State defense. This is a very solid defensive ball club.
Wills, good rebound, double and fouled inside. Kelly was there, and Shaq Morris is going to be on Kelly. Shaq was going, please don't call it on me.
Morris is thinking, I gotta hide somehow so these guys don't see me.
Here is Tony Wills, a senior from Indianapolis, Indiana, Ben Davis High School. His brother plays some college basketball at Vermont. No matter what team you root for, there's one thing we can all agree on. Everybody loves donuts. Superior Donuts, new episode tomorrow, 9, 8 Central. Only CBS. Truer words have never been spoken.
Well, I know you're a big donut guy.
To be a big everything guy.
Another area where Illinois State has hurt themselves today, Kevin, is they have not shot the ball well from the free throw line. They haven't had that many opportunities, but they haven't been able to convert them.
Yes, 7 of their last 13 free throws. Redbirds have Frank Hamp. Sham it back in. I guess that leg injury not too serious. Shot clock at four. Sham it a two. McIntosh, the rebound. He's got five.
Well, unless Illinois State can put points on the board, a possession like that works much in favor of Wichita State because they run so much time off the clock.
McIntosh. He nails it. He is two of nine, and he's got five.
Well, and you have enough time. You have to play perfectly almost, but you have enough time that you can get back in the game.
Frankamp to Kelly. Kelly to Frankamp underneath. Wills swiping it away, and a foul called on Tony Wills. .729 to go. The winner gets an automatic bid to the NCAA tournament as you're watching the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship on CBS.
The ingredients here at Chipotle are the finest in all of the land. So at their request, we threw them a fest to honor their flavors so grand.
Like, really good.
They insisted we prepare them by hand as we showered them with seasoning and praise. Entertaining and marinating, sauteing and celebrating, 'twas truly the most delicious of days.
We're led to believe each individual point is worth the same amount, regardless of when it's scored. Layups are always worth 2 points, theoretically. But fans know that's not the case. Because here, in the last minute, everything counts for just a little bit more. Under 30 seconds, three-pointers tend to feel like five. As for buzzer beaters, they're worth the whole shebang.
Shockers playing their game. They've got plus 10 points off turnovers. You see the difference in three-point shooting and the score. 14-point lead now for Wichita State. If Illinois State does not win this game, Dan, and of course we know the winner gets an automatic bid to the tournament, the committee, I guess, is watching right now, right? They're seeing what this team that would be on the bubble of Illinois State is doing.
Well, the committee watches an awful lot of basketball, and you have to say that Illinois State has not looked particularly good today. They have not shot the ball well. Their defense has been outstanding. But I think the members of the committee are attuned enough to the game of college basketball to understand that a game like this is often not a pretty game. There's so much pressure on the teams. They're both such good defensive teams. It's hard to have this kind of a game be fluid. So I'm not sure that it'll hurt Illinois State that badly if they end up losing the game. But certainly it will put the decision in the hands of the committee because they won't get the automatic bid.
Frankamp at the line with 16, of course, comes from Wichita, played at North High School. That long line of terrific players from Wichita. We mentioned Darnell Valentine, Ricky Ross, Aubrey Sherrod, Perry Ellis, who had a long career at Kansas. It turned out a lot of them. Valentine, one of the first real early terrific players. Hawkins, triple. Maybe a bit on the line, actually. There's a foul on Kelly of Wichita State away from the ball. Greg Marshall.
McIntosh does a great job trying to get in position, and I think the problem was that miss was such a long miss that Kelly had great position to start with, but then he just kept moving underneath McIntosh.
Kelly picks up his third. McIntosh at the stripe. For the Illinois State Redbirds, they had four starters and seven lettermen returned from a second-place team of a year ago when they went 18-14. And McIntosh being one of them.
Referee Mike Stewart having something to say to Landry Shamit on the free throw line. Again, these two teams do not particularly like one another. And I didn't see what Shamit did, but Mike Stewart was not happy about it.
Mike Stewart has officiated five Final Fours. I think he knows what he's doing. They got him in a straight jacket. And
they fouled it.
They sure did. Evans got him. Keyshawn Evans with the foul. That's the second on Keyshawn.
And now, of course, they're in the double bonus, so they're going to be shooting two every time. And Frank Camp is a 79% free throw shooter.
He is the city of Wichita's all-time leading high school scorer. That says something with the kind of talent we were rattling off a moment ago. Shockers are never trailing. McIntosh will drive. McDuffie a little bit late. Morris is there to meet him at the rim.
See, and one of the reasons why a game like this cannot be pretty is you don't really get opportunities to get all the way to the rim. You start to the rim and somebody's going to foul you because these are two hard-nosed, intense defensive teams.
Mikhail McIntosh. He had 15 yesterday against Southern Illinois. Top offensive rebounders in the conference and the 14th leading scorer in the Valley. Under seven to play.
Now for Wichita State, you don't want to be conservative here. The lead seems bigger than 13, but it is only 13 points. You get a couple of stops, you make a couple of threes, and Illinois State is right back in business.
Good passing by Wichita State. McDuffie trying to go in. Evans was reaching in on the wing and picks up a foul. Evans with number three.
It's going to be hard for somebody to make a basket if they get fouled. Every time down the court, it's the only thing we ever have is free throws.
Marcus McDuffie was the Missouri Valley Conference Freshman of the Year a season ago, and he's playing with his teammate Landry Shamit, who is this year's Freshman of the Year.
Now, Kevin, I noticed, according to the official stats, that he does not have a field goal today. I thought he'd scored a field goal earlier, but officially,
he's 0-4, you're right.
They have him with no field goals, but he's made all seven of his free throw attempts. And I think that's one of the characteristics of this Wichita State team, that even if you can't do what you normally do, make yourself useful, and that's what they do.
Rebound by Rashard Kelly.
Chairman saying, give me the ball. You know, go down the court. I'll take care of this.
Wichita State a season ago was the last team in the tournament. Well, they made it.
And they went and won two games.
They sure did. Can't quickly double. Shot clock down to five. Push on Lee. The feed to Shamit on the move. But flies away.
Oh, that's a killer. That's just a killer. They run 30 seconds off the shot clock and then score.
They got
right the buzzer. Lead. Yeah, and right. they even get a couple more seconds to run off the game clock because the ball bounces around.
Drive by Lee. Rebound pulled down by Kelly. And they will take their time, and Shamit comes up limping at the other end. Shamit, the season ended last year with a stress fracture. He took the red shirt. He's out there right now, and he is hobbling noticeably. He's a vital player for this team.
Yeah, he sure is. I'm really impressed with the way he handles himself. Very poised out on the court.
Rashard Kelly, Shaq Morris the rebound. Back into Kelly, shoved, and he'll go to the line.
Well, Kelly has had some point-blank range opportunities that he has not been able to convert. But as we said with Kelly, he's a hustle guy. He plays hard.
Well, the leading scorer this season from Illinois State has just fouled out Deontay Hawkins.
And Landry Shamet is jogging up and down the court here while they try to get straightened out.
You know, they were looking at his leg on the sideline earlier, but I'm not sure if it was the leg that he has hurt here. And a technical foul has just been thrown on Illinois State, but I'm not sure if I've got on Hawkins.
If they call a technical foul on Hawkins, isn't he done?
Yeah, he was, yeah. He's gone. Here's McDuffie at the line. Leading scorer, leading rebounder. Hawkins is a senior from Dayton.
Really tough game for Hawkins.
Hawkins originally signed with Wichita State. You may recall he played at Dunbar High School in Dayton.
Well, here's Hawkins. Let's see what he does.
Yeah, that was it.
Oh, gee.
He was the Dayton High School Player of the Year. Originally signed with Wichita State. They're making him leave the floor. That was a very ceremonious way to end your college career. At this level, and maybe he'll play in the tournament. But today, in the Valley Championship game, not a good way to end it. Kelly at the line.
He's very frustrated. Very frustrated all day. He had a couple of opportunities to make three-point shots and was only able to get 1-3 to go down. I thought they played pretty good defense against him. Then in the second half, he got in foul trouble and just very frustrated. That's a shame.
Morris gets the ball. McDuffie pops a triple. The coup de grace, the door has been slammed. And Wichita State with their biggest lead and looking good doing it. McIntosh, that is a foul. And it goes on Kelly at the other end.
Well, we talked about McDuffie, how he has not shot the ball well. Hasn't really taken that many shots, but there in a big moment, he knocks down the three. Yep. Have every reason to be excited, young man.
You can feel it now with 4:53 to go. The momentum clearly in the hands of Wichita State. The top scorer and rebounder is not only fouled out of the game and was ineffective, but now they've taken him off the bench into the locker room. They also lost Phil Fain, who was a very good shot blocker and rebounder on this team. So the numbers are dwindling. And you're shooting 30%, and you got to hit your free throw.
Well, they have shot under 30% from the field overall in the second half.
Yes, they have.
I'm not sure they've made a three here in the second half.
They have not. The row of eight.
So you're 0-8-3 in the second half. You're shooting under 30% overall. You're having a tough time from the free throw line. And even though Wichita State has, you know, the offensive numbers for them, they're shooting right about 40%. They haven't been outstanding, but it's been enough.
That ball was deflected in mid-flight. Injai comes up with it. The missed shot by Framkamp, and here comes Lee.
And Lee has been the one bright spot today.
18 points. You got to play with urgency right now if you're the Redbirds. McIntosh, triple. Good shot. Good shot. He's got 13.
They need a lot more of that in a hurry.
We'll see a lot of this full court in Framkamp. And now he gets it out to Austin Reeves and down court. Ooh, he hit the deck hard. McDuffie was fouled as he was going in there, and it looked like McIntosh was the one to pick up a foul. McIntosh with his fourth.
That's a great job by Wichita State to break the pressure. And then when you can beat the pressure and you can get it up court to a guy like McDuffie.
He's been to Wichita State. Yeah, we talked about that, Dan, earlier on too. Frank Kemp's going to sit out. Here comes Reeves to the sideline. They bring back in Smith. They bring in Zach Brown. But this bench and the depth of Wichita State, I think, having its way and taking its toll on Illinois State now.
Well, keep in mind, Kevin, that Shaq Morris, we talked about him before the game, but he got in foul trouble. He went to the bench. Willis came in and did a nice job.
Njai with a screen for McIntosh, and another three by McIntosh. He now has 16. McIntosh. And Wills was defending Deshaun Smith on the inbound. We step aside at the State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Championship.
The ingredients here at Chipotle are the finest in all of the land. So at their request, we threw them a fest to honor their flavors so grand.
Like, really good.
They insisted we prepare them by hand, as we showered them with seasoning and praise. Entertaining and marinating, sautéing and celebrating, 'twas truly the most delicious of days.
What powers the digital world? Communication. That's why a cutting-edge university counts on CenturyLink to keep their global campus connected. And why a pro football team chose us to deliver fiber-enabled broadband to more than 65,000 fans. And why a leading car brand counts on us to keep their dealer networks streamlined and nimble. Businesses count on communication, and communication counts on CenturyLink. CenturyLink, your link to what's next.
Go-to's USAA. Everyone knows that, especially everyone in the military. Even though I'm out of the military, they refer to me as my rank. It shows that USAA serves as military members and I'm part of that community that they serve.
Wichita State has never trailed. They've led by as many as 23 points as we now take a look at our AT&T Fast Analysis.
And one of the big factors in the game for Wichita State has been Connor Frankamp. He's been able to get open for three. You see here, he's got the ball. The two defenders come to him because he's been so good from three. So he just splits the defenders, gets into the middle of that zone, and makes the two. Frankamp has 18 points on the game. Three twos, three threes, couple of free throws. He's the guy that really got Wichita State rolling early.
Over on the sideline, John Schriffen.
Well, guys, with the fouls starting to rack up and this game getting really physical and chippy, Greg Marshall went over to his team, sat them down on the bench and said, guys, we will be playing in another game. Don't do anything stupid out here, Kevin.
It looks like right now they're zeroing in on another ace NCAA tournament, and they've, right with the 3:50 to go,
they've only got 6 seconds to get it over the line.
They sure do. Trying to win the Missouri Valley Conference Championship tournament game for the first time since 2014. There's a foul on Paris Lee. He's got his first.
Well, the interesting thing about this Wichita State program, as dominant as they have been over Greg Marshall's, the recent years at least of Greg Marshall's tenure here, they have never really done very well in the Missouri Valley tournament, particularly here in St. Louis.
They've gone to the semifinals 8 consecutive years, but they won in 2014.
And that's it.
Yeah. You got to go back to the 80s.
Yeah.
Find some time, and you can see the last 6 champions. That Northern Iowa run was good, and they had a hell of a heck of a win the Northern Iowa team did last year with that last-second shot that bounced on the rim.
Yeah.
John Smith at the line. Points off turnovers have been significant, too. Plus 10 in that category for the Shockers of Wichita State. 3.5 to go. McIntosh with a couple of threes. And Jai is at the screen, and that one is launched and missed by Tony Wills.
And Shaq Morris, who spent a lot of the time on the bench in foul trouble, is now he's getting closing in on double-figure rebounds. That was his 9th rebound of the game.
With Kelly and Brown and Shannon. Under 3 to go. 3, no. And Smith was launching.
But again, they got to stop. Can the Redbirds score now?
And McIntosh way off on that shot with the rebound by Morris. The body language of Illinois State not very good. And that's a 10th rebound, by the way, for Shaquille Morris.
Right, you've got to go down and you've got to take threes, and you have to take them quickly. So obviously very discouraging for Illinois State. This is a mountain that's just going to be a little bit too big to climb today.
Down the drive, Clayton defending. And Clayton picks up the foul. DJ Clayton from Oakland, California. His first of the afternoon. Well, they've had an incredible season, 17-1. The only loss in the regular year was to Wichita State, and they were without Mikhail McIntosh in this game. They beat Wichita State at home, part of an undefeated home record. And their coach was the coach of the year in the conference. They're in the championship game. The first time in a long time. The player of the year, the defensive player of the year on their team. It was an incredible regular season for Illinois State. Wills, three, short, Fran Camp.
As we said, they made 9 of 15 threes in the first half yesterday. Simply haven't been able to get the three to go today. It's been a very frustrating afternoon. And one thing Dan Muller told us when we said, well, what are the important things for us? We have to make shots, and they just haven't done so. You know, their defense has been okay. Wichita State shooting under 40%.
Reeves the drive and a bump into him, maybe McIntosh. And
another technical foul.
Well, that was on McIntosh. And Dan Muller over there telling his kids to be quiet. He's frustrated, and team incredibly frustrated. Bring in Madison Williams, who is a freshman from Augusta, Georgia. And Frank Camp will take the shots. McIntosh has 5.
So they'll shoot the technical free throw first, and then they'll pick up with the free throws. There was a foul. The foul was on Wills. The technical was on McIntosh.
Redbirds had won 19 of 21 coming in an 8th straight. And they began the season 2-2. People forget that. Their season was off to a little bit of a rough start. Muller talks with McIntosh. Personal and tech on McIntosh. He's gone. Reeves is at the line. Austin Reeves, Arkansas. 3-time state champion at Cedar Ridge High School.
Wichita State has suddenly gone cold from the free throw line. It's like they've missed 4 of their last 5.
12 second half, Dan, you talked about this moments ago. Illinois State shooting 27% from the field. The lead triple, no.
Kevin, there's a misconception out there that defense wins you championships. And the reality of the situation is that defense puts you in position to win games and win championships. But eventually, you've got to put the ball in the basket, and Illinois State simply could not do that today. And you got to remember, they weren't out there by themselves. Wichita State gets a lot of the credit for that.
Frank Camp, 3. Mercer was in there battling with DJ Clayton of Illinois State, and it sails out of bounds. If they go on to win, and everything would point in that direction, Wichita State will win their 30th game of the season and 30 wins for the fourth time in 5 years. There goes Darrell Willis Jr. There goes Kelly. There goes Frankamp. Good game by the Shockers.
And it was a real team game. Some of their big-name players or their guys who you normally expect are going to score points did not. We said Shaquille Morris went to the bench with foul trouble, but Nerger and Willis picked up the slack. A real team effort.
Some walk-ons on before now. John Robert Simon from Oklahoma City is in. C.J. Kaiser is in. He's a freshman from Baltimore. Reeves with it. Also out there, Zach Bush. And Eric Hamilton out there for the Shockers. Kids that part of the program, a lot of them young. Future of the team, Kaiser. Working into Wills. Rebound by Clayton. Sixth consecutive NCAA tournament for Wichita State. Six in a row. That ties a Missouri Valley Conference record of Cincinnati in the late 50s and early 60s, and a guy named Oscar Robertson was playing at that time for Cincinnati. The automatic tournament bid for the Shockers with the win today.
So the big question for Wichita State was, could they get an at-large bid if they lost this game? Well, don't need to even worry about that. They're going to get the automatic bid.
The shot by Javonka Thompson. That's it. Wichita State is going to the dance. We've got three teams in the Big South.